Most Americans still have no idea that there are harmful or questionable ingredients in the products that they put on their largest organ every single day. Americans think that the products on the shelves are safe. Increasingly, they're starting to question that fact. I'm Gregg Renfrew, and I'm the founder and CEO of Beautycounter. I started Beautycounter to bring products into the market that were high performing, that were also significantly safer for health. The EU has banned or restricted approximately 1,400 ingredients from all personal care and cosmetic products. And when I started the company, the United States had banned 11 ingredients. Now we've banned a total of 30. And not 30,000, 30. So we are dangerously far behind the times. In the beginning, we had to figure out, first of all, what ingredients we could use. We had to screen tons of chemicals and try to figure out, okay, which ones did we believe were safer for health? Which ones did we not want to use? We looked for endocrine disrupting chemicals, those that created reproductive toxicity, neurotoxicity, or cancer. And we've removed a couple hundred ingredients that are not currently banned or restricted in the EU. It took us a couple of years and millions of dollars to actually bring the first products to market. And we launched with an essential skin and body care line that was about 11 products in the beginning. I think we now have 175. We had our e-commerce platform, beautycounter.com, and we also had our network of independent consultants. And we chose to sell our products through people because we really felt our story was best told person to person. When we created this direct retail model, this multi-channeled approach to business, the women, as part of the movement, were a byproduct of what we set out to do. In doing that, we empowered all these women with this economic opportunity and the opportunity to be part of a movement and be part of something that's bigger than any one of them individually. For me, the mission is everything. I want women's health to be protected, and I felt that the world didn't need just another beauty brand. What they needed was a movement for better beauty. It's not easy to change the industry. And when we started Beautycounter, we were the first company to really get out there and say, look, we are going to hold you all accountable, you, the government, and ourselves as a company. Our industry has changed dramatically. Part of the meaningful change that's occurred in the beauty industry is because of our leadership. We're really proud of how vocal we've been and how we've brought other companies along with us. We want to chart our own course. And we believe we can move the whole industry to a better place by leading by example.